Hey there, Vikings. Welcome back to VVN News. We got another jam-packed episode for you guys. Let's jump right in.
What's up, Vikings? The Little Shop of Horrors spring production is taking place April 18th, 19th, 25th, and 26th at 7 p.m. and on April 20th at 1 p.m. It'll take place in the cafetorium, and tickets are available for $5 from the activities office or any cast member.
Two women were attacked along the Venice Canal. Both women were struck from behind, and it is believed that the same person was behind the attacks. The same attacker also attempted to break into a house a couple times, but was unsuccessful. Also, 162 years ago, President Abraham Lincoln signed a bill ending slavery in the District of Columbia.
What's up, Vikings? Today, the 16th, Boys Varsity Tennis will play against El Monte away. The matches start at 3:30. Boys Varsity Volleyball will have their senior night home against El Monte. The game starts at 3:30. Wednesday the 17th, All Track will have their senior night away against Marshall at 3:30. Varsity and JV Baseball will play against Gabrielino, with Varsity playing home and JV away. Both games start at 3:30. Varsity Softball will have their senior night home against Gabrielino. The game starts at 3:30. JV Softball will also play against Gabrielino away, starting at 3:30. Thursday the 18th, Boys Varsity Volleyball will play against South El Monte away. The game starts at 3:30. Boys Varsity and JV Tennis will play against South El Monte, with Varsity playing away and JV home. Both games start at 3:30. Friday the 19th, Varsity and JV Baseball play against El Monte, with Varsity playing away and JV home. Both games start at 3:30. Varsity and JV Softball will play against El Monte, with Varsity playing away and JV home. Both games start at 3:30. That's all for sports this week. See you guys next week.
On April 16th, it's National Orchid Day. On the 17th, it's National Banana Day. On the 18th, it's National Exercise Day. And on the 19th, it's National Hanging Out Day.
Hey Vikings, welcome to this week's gossip segment. This week's bit of gossip surrounds ex-convict Gypsy Rose Blanchard, who was released from prison after being an accomplice to her mother's murder. Gypsy and her ex-husband got married while she was serving her sentence back in July of 2022. After her early release from prison last year, Gypsy and her husband looked happier than ever on a press tour. However, as of Monday, April 8th, 2024, Gypsy has filed for divorce with no explanation. That's it from me, Vikings. Have a great rest of your day. See you next time.
Hey Vikings, today's movie recommendation is Teen Beach. Two young surfers get swept away by a huge wave. They act in a real-life version of the 1960s film West Side Story, but their presence derails the movie's plot, so they must fix it. That's all for me, Vikings. Have a great day.
Hey Vikings, the winner of last week's poll is Disneyland, winning by 65% and Universal Studios with 35%. Fun fact about Universal Studios, you can mail letters from Harry Potter World. This week's poll is Spotify or Apple Music. If you would like to go vote, go and check out MVHS VISTA on our Instagram.
Hey Vikings, today's recommendation is The Office. This series follows the staff of the paper company, Dunder Mifflin. The Office is an American mockumentary sitcom television series that depicts the everyday work lives of office employees. The Office is available on Peacock and Amazon Prime. Have a great rest of your day, Vikings.
Hey Vikings, this week's song recommendation is Money Trees by Kendrick Lamar.
Everybody go respect the shooter, but the one in front of the lives forever.
The one in front of the forever.
And I've been.
Don't mind where I am now. This will be the last time. Anyways, what time is it? Oh, I was not told about how this was released this year. That's right. Blue Archive. No, wait. Ow, Odie. Oh, not this again.
I'm not dealing with this, alright? Oh, you think this is a game?
You think this is a game?
I'll show you a game!
Wrong one. Ow, no Exorcist, aka Blue Exorcist. That's the one. I recently learned that the third season came out this year. The first season came out in 2011. 13 years ago, so it has been a while. In the world of Blue Exorcist, the world can be separated into two pieces. Asaya, the human world, and Gehenna, the spiritual world. It's like two sides of a coin. Gehenna? Problem solver 68. Anyways, you could think of Gehenna as a demon world. As it turns out, Rin Okimura is a very special person. He is one of two twin sons of Satan. A telling sign of his heritage is its blue flames, which is cool as hell. See? Anarchy? Also a symbol for Satan in this world. This explains why he was so physically strong even as a kid, but it does have drawbacks, such as a bunch of demons coming to him for whatever reasons they have, and exorcists trying to assassinate him. Against everyone assuming he's gonna be evil, Rin is gonna use his demonic gifts for good and become an exorcist to become even stronger to protect everyone he cares about. You remember how I said Rin was one of two sons? Rin's younger brother is Yukio. He didn't inherit any cool demonic powers, but luckily, he does akimbo pistols, which is a fair trade. Hold on. Twins of a demon, Satan in this case, one dual-wield pistols. Another uses a katana and also has a blue aura. And they were both motivated by becoming stronger. And during the course of the story, they also fight demons and stuff. This is like the hit anime Devil May Cry, adapted from the hip game Devil May Cry. Anyways, done.
It Takes Two is a cooperative action-adventure platform video game. In this game, you play as a clashing couple, Cody and May, two humans turned into dolls because of a magic spell. Together, they go on an unpredictable adventure. This game was released for PlayStation, Xbox, and Windows.
Did someone say Devil May Cry? Well, anyways, that's all for this week's episode. See you next time.